Hi, everybody, and welcome to Moodle Support Theater. This series of videos is designed to take you through the steps to add an assignment to your course page. We're working in version 2.8, and we are in a class setup page we've built for Moodle. We're going to come to the upper right-hand corner and turn our editing on. That's going to turn the green button to red. Now we're going to come to the upper left-hand corner, and where it says navigation, and this is just something I prefer to do, but it's really turned out to be quite useful. In the upper right-hand corner of navigation, you have the option to either hide the block, which is the left-hand choice, or the right-hand will dock it. I'm going to click Dock Navigation Block, and that moves that whole item to the upper left-hand corner. If you float your mouse, it will appear, but it gives us the administration block at the top, and that's very, very useful. That's something that you'll be using quite a bit in your class. When editing is turned on, you'll notice Add an Activity or Resource is available. Let's go to the week of May 13th and select Add an Activity or Resource. There's a whole list of things to do, and we'll be going over most of them. Today we're going to choose Assignment. That's the very first item. Click the box, come down to the bottom and choose Add, and here we go. We're setting up an assignment for our class. For brand new persons, I like to suggest the Expand All button here in the upper right hand corner. This opens up every option on the page to give you an opportunity to peruse it and decide if you wish to include it in your class. Assignment name is required. I'm simply going to type in Paper 1. Description is also required. I have a preloaded description. I've typed this and I'm cutting and pasting it into my description box. You may also type directly. If it's long, mine is not that bad, so I'm going to come right down below and display the description on the course page. That'll show up in the front. A very long description, it's up to you how much front page real estate you want to give up. Generally, the longer, the better it is for a student, and that'll show up in the assignment area, and you'll be seeing that in other videos. If you have an additional file, a study guide, for example, you can drag and drop that file, or where it says File, you can use the old school Browse and Upload. Availability, by default, Enable here on the right-hand side is checked for the due dates, and the day you are creating this item is the day that it's going to allow submissions from. You may remove the checks, and I'm just going to click both of those boxes, and you notice it now grays out and it has no date capability. If I just want to include a due date, which I'm going to choose here, I'm going to use my drop-down for the first and make it the 14th. The month I'm going to do June, and if you notice right next to the Enable, and frankly this is the method I like best, I choose the calendar, click on the day I want, and it becomes a part of the record. Cutoff date is optional, that's up to you. Let's scroll down a little more. Submission types. Generally, file submissions are the type of information you're going to be using. Online text is not recommended because it tends to time out and cause users some difficulty and increase frustration. Online audio recording is also an availability, and we'll be going into that in depth in another session. Maximum number of recordings, of course, will appear if online video is selected. Allow student to change the file name. Generally, that's up to you. Maximum number of files to upload, that's up to you. Maximum submission size, we've set it to 10 megabytes. That's a pretty good hunk of data. Anything much better than that, like a huge PDF or a huge video file, please contact Media Services and they will assist you in handling large documents or large video processes. As we continue to look at submission types, there's default file name pattern and word limit. Those two are connected. Those two are advanced, and we'll have those in our advanced video series. Feedback type, generally feedback comments is given. You can also have offline and feedback files. Comment inline is generally not recommended because you get very large documents in very small spaces, and readability and usability can be impacted. Now, require students click the submit button. 98% of the time, this is going to be no. If you have a back and forth, multiple draft, multiple revision, then you would come down to the bottom of this section where it says maximum attempts, and you can make some settings, and then you would turn that on. Again, there is, we'll talk more about this in another video. Group submission settings, students are able to submit in groups if you choose. That does require that you create a group for the class, and notifications generally no. For all choices. Default setting for notify students. Some people like it, some people don't. That's a discussion you should have with your students, and it's kind of important because people get pretty hot under the collar about email. Okay, when we come back next time in setting up assignments, we're going to talk about the Turnitin setting. We're going to stop there. Remind you, you can stop into the Moodle office for help. We're here Monday through Friday, 8 to 5 in Library 315, and we're looking forward to seeing you soon.